banita DJ Spin aka Spin Imana aka umukozi w'Imana. And of course buri munsi always watch TV7, especially this show itwa Gospel Celebs, kiganiro kiza cyane. Don't miss out each and every week with your boy Florando Tie. I'll see you. Ciao.
I'm now delighted to welcome our guest today, who is now with me here in the studio. But first of all, we'll start with your introduction to our viewers who are watching us wherever they are now.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for having me. My name is Aaron Warden, a nutritional therapist from the UK. And this is my first time in Rwanda, so I'm very blessed to be here, and I'm very blessed to have the opportunity to share with you who we are and what we do.
Why had you delayed to visit Rwanda?
You know, nothing before its time. Everything at the appointed time.
You're right. Yeah. Welcome to Rwanda.
Thank you.
Especially this show, which is called The Gospel Celebs. We mainly host various people who are involved in the gospel industry, who are changing lives of different people in Rwanda, either through gospel or either through humanitarian activities. Now, why are you here in Kigali today?
Okay. The reason for my visit to Rwanda, Kigali, is I'm supporting my sister, Jackie. She has an amazing project called the Change Life Initiative, where she is helping to support the victims of genocide who have no family, have no support systems. And she has a project to help them to provide funds for themselves. So we're supporting her. We've been supporting her from the UK with that project to help provide machines and resources to give the women a means to be able to, you know, feed themselves. But because we've been supporting her from a distance, I thought it's only apt for me to come and see exactly what she's doing on the ground firsthand.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I think God will help you to expand your activities in different corners of the country. But we knew that when you came, you also visited the Genocide Memorial Center, which our technician is going to help us to see how it was at the memorial. And we talk about what you've learned so far, what you have experienced talking to those beneficiaries of such activities, also talking to different people at the Genocide Memorial site. Which message did you pick from what you saw yourself on the ground?
When people talk about the survivors of the genocide, victims of genocide, just mentioning the genocide, you automatically focus on the women and the people that are here and that they must have lost a lot and now they're trying to put their lives together. When I went to the memorial center, and I saw what they actually went through, the massacre, the sufferation, you know, the annihilation of their families, their loved ones, the loss that they suffered, the reasons, the inhumanity of the genocide. It was very moving. It was very, it brought it all home. You really realize how much has been taken from these women, from these people on the whole. And it showed the magnanimity of this issue that they'd experienced. And it gave me a whole new perspective on, you know, the whole genocide. I now I'm going back with a more invigorated aspiration and inspiration to do as much as we can to really help these women, because they need the support. They've got, everything has been taken from them. Family members, mothers, fathers, generations have been just taken, gone. So we need to do as much as we can to help these women to be able to help themselves.
And you are doing this through an initiative called Change Life.
Yes, Change Life Initiative. This is Jackie Mugabu, is her project, her initiative, that she's initiated off the back of her own motivation to help these women, because she has a very good heart. She has a very good heart for people and a very good heart for helping. And when she did her presentation in the UK and I saw it, I was moved to help her, to empower her, to encourage her, and to support her, to make sure that she's able to be as effective as she can, because she's taken on a lot. And I find that through the Change Life Initiative, she's got some very committed volunteers, and the fact that she has them, she just needs a strong team of people around her.
Sisterhood.
the sisterhood. That's it, the sisterhood. Those sisters are doing an amazing work, and I really have to commend them. If you're watching, you know, thumbs up to the great work you're doing. We're here to support you and do our best to help you, to help the women that are trying to help themselves.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. For those who are watching us, wherever you are, this is the CEO of MI Healthcare. His name is Mr. Aaron Warden from the UK. He's now in Rwanda, partnering with Jackie Mugabo in different humanitarian activities, which are still going on. And shortly we'll be hosting her live here in the studio. Let me wish you a very nice weekend
thank
with
you.
Kigali here in Kigali.
Oh, yes. Thank you so much. Thank you
so much.
Thank you. Bless you.
Thank you. We're still with Warden, but shortly we'll be receiving Jackie Mugabo. And now we are going to watch one of her videos before we host her live.
Wow. Fantastic.